dynamic testing is the final stages of testing of the key railway system. So it's the integration of fundamentals of the signalling system, the train-borne systems and the wayside. So it's that final part before we enter into trial running. So it's a key component. As a Crossrail project, we call this the RCC, which is the route control centre. So everything's controlled front end from here. So in the control room floor, you have people looking after the traction power, the non-traction power, the TOM systems, and the signalling systems as well. So from a testing perspective, this is the central hub to allow to complete dynamic testing. It's fundamental for us to test the system thoroughly. So it takes as long as it takes to get us to a point where the systems will be signed off as safe, allowing obviously us to move into trial running, then into trial operations and into passenger service as well. The testing is key in relation to core safety requirements, basically.
Change, we're going to be moving from the eastbound over to the westbound, perform manual cab change and then move to Bond Street, where we're going to continue with the PSD test.
From a testing perspective, we start with one train. The process of testing with one train is slow speed testing with non-signalling. Then you move up to the signalling control perspective of it. After various stages of assurance, then you need to step up to multi-train testing. From a maximum allowed units in dynamic testing, it's four trains.
So you want me to go back to one of the turnbacks and then switch cabs, or?
Yeah, that's correct. We'll set your route at the turnback alpha first run, yeah?
Okay.
Yeah. We have to test the functionality and requirements of each of the core systems, i.e. so you're testing the train, you're testing the signalling system, you're testing the power system, you're testing the comm system, you're testing the platform screen doors. We need to demonstrate in an integrated manner that the trains operate safely and correctly. We have to reach these core requirements and assurance as well before moving into the next stage of testing. What we do in dynamic testing, we find many and multiple different faults. That's the reason we test, because you wouldn't want these faults to come up during an operational railway. So again, it could be any number of matters. It's usually due to with interfaces. We've got key systems that are obviously operating independently, but they need to be working as in unison as a whole. So again, the big part for us is the integration side of it. I don't believe people realise how much integration and planning goes into what we're trying to deliver here, yeah. You're talking multiple stakeholders, so this could be around an involvement of one test window for us, maybe 150 to 200 people that are involved directly, and then you maybe have 50 to 60 people that are back behind that were in relation to the planning. And we're testing a system that runs from the southeast of London across to the west, with 10 new stations being built. So you're interfacing and integrating with these people all the time. And again, the key fundamental for us is safety. The systems have to be safe, one, to allow us to start testing, and then for us to obviously complete the testing as well.